John Brown went off to war to fight on a foreign shore. His mother sure was proud of him. And he stood so straight and tall with his uniform and all. Her face broke right out into a grin. She said, "Son, you look so fine. I'm glad you're a son of mine. Makes me proud to know that you wear a gun. Do what that captain says. Lots of medals you will get. And we'll put them on the wall when you come home." When that old train pulled out, John's mom began to shout, telling everybody in the neighborhood, "That's my son who's about to go. He's a soldier now, you know." She made well sure her neighbors understood. She got a letter once in a while, and her face broke into a smile, showing them to her friend from next door. And she bragged about her son with his uniform and gun, and this thing she called a good old-fashioned war. Then the letter ceased to come. For a long time it did not come. And they ceased to come for about 10 months or more. Then a letter finally came, saying, "Go down and meet the train. Your sons are coming home from the war." Oh, she smiled and went right down. She looked up and all around, but her soldier son's face she didn't see inside. But when all the people passed, she saw her son at last. When she did, she could hardly believe her eyes. For his face was all shot up, and his hands were both blown off, and he wore a metal brace around his waist. And he whispered kind of slow in a voice she did not know. She couldn't even recognize his face. She said, "Oh, my darling son, Lord, what they gone and done? How is it that you come to be this way?" When the boy tried to speak, his mouth could hardly move, and his mother had to turn her face away. He said, "Do you remember, Ma, when I went off to war? You thought it was the best thing that I could do. I was on that battleground. You were home acting proud. Thank God you wasn't standing in my shoes. And you know when I was there, I said, what am I doing here? I've got to kill somebody or die trying. But the thing that scared me most, when my enemy came so close, I could see that his face looked just like mine. Through the thunder, wind, and stink, I couldn't help but think that I'm just a puppet in a play. Through the thunder, wind, and smoke, the string it finally broke, and a cannonball blew my eyes away. When the boy turned to walk, His mother was still in shock as she saw that metal brace which helped him stand. But when he turned to go, he called his mother close and he dropped his medals down into her hand.